Even with phones getting bigger and sleeker every single day, do you still find that your thumbs barely hit the right keys? Would you way rather type than text? That is 100% me. As much as I love Instagram, I hate being on my phone. So whenever possible, I use Instagram from desktop. So today I'm gonna share how you can use Instagram from your desktop, plus all my favorite tools to make it happen. And stay to the end where I'm gonna give a sneak peek at my favorite tool that I use to actually run my entire agency. So all of my client accounts are run through this tool, and that means I'm never having to post from my phone. Switching to desktop has worked wonders for my friend and client, Kara Gray, who quit her job of 20 years, I know, to run her own Instagram agency for realtors in Chicago.
I quit my job of 20 years as an executive assistant at the end of 2017 and started my business full time in January.
And is she on her phone all day? Nope, she has switched to using Instagram on desktop. I'm Elise Darma, and I've taught thousands of entrepreneurs like yourself how to use Instagram to grow your business. And today I'm sharing how you can use Instagram from your desktop. Welcome to Instagram on desktop. So when you go to Instagram.com and sign into your account, this is the view that you're going to see. So you do see your news feed right away. And over on the right, you see stories. So from this column, you can view stories and you can also follow accounts. So when you're looking at your newsfeed, you can do everything like and comment. You can write a comment right here and hit post. And then going back to your stories, if you want to have a look at them right here, you simply click on the colored ring and it will pop up.
If you do focus on becoming, you can do things.
So if you want to pause it, you just bring your mouse over on the story and press down. So I've paused Amy for now. And if you want to move forward, you just hit the right arrow.
That you never build them up so much.
And then when you're done with it, you hit the X. So that's the home screen of Instagram.com. The other thing to take note is the search bar. I use this search bar all the time, especially when I'm doing hashtag research. So to give you an idea, if I want to look for hashtags related to, let's say, travel Europe, this might be super specific, but let's see. What we get is we get hashtag travel Europe right at the top, but then what I love is the drop down menu of hashtag suggestions. So this is really great for when you need to look for smaller hashtags. So we can also do let's do a big one like Boss Babe. Now, of course, Boss Babe has over 12 million posts. That's really big. But if we want to look for something more specific, we've got Boss Babe Co, Boss Babe Life, and these are smaller hashtags. So these are better for our targeting. So this is absolutely where I love to do hashtag research. It's also where I can find people's profiles. So again, if I wanted to go to Amy's profile, who I already just watched her story, just start typing in her name and then click on the profile and we're transported over to her profile. From what we can see on desktop, we can pretty much see everything that we get on mobile, right? We get the stories, we get the bio, we get the link in bio, we get the highlights here, then we have the feed, and we can even see what posts that she's tagged in. So again, if we want to see her highlight on Scout, just move your mouse on over and click it, and it will start to play once it loads. And again, you can see this actually from 81 weeks ago. So Amy's had this one up for a while, but it's just a really quick and easy way to see someone's highlights. And then when we're done, we just exit out of it. All right, so if we ever want to go back to the home screen, we just hit this button here. Now I want to take you over to my profile. I also want to show you that notifications show up here on desktop as well. So let's go over to my home profile. And this is what my own profile looks like on desktop. This is really where I love to do my editing. So when I want to change up my bio and I want to make sure I have these beautiful line breaks, I usually go to edit profile over on my desktop. And this is what I will actually edit. So I'll type it all right here. I'll make sure there's no spaces in between my lines, and that's how I get my beautiful line breaks. This is also where you get access to some settings as well. Not all of them, but just some of them. So going back, this is basically what you see for your profile. You can see again the posts that you've shared in your feed. Now my profile right here is a little bit more built up than Amy's. I have an IGTV channel, so if you want to view or even upload your videos to IGTV, you can do this all right here on desktop. At this time of recording, if your video is longer than 10 minutes, you won't be able to upload it on mobile. So this is exactly how you would do it, through this button. So that's your IGTV channel. If you ever want to direct someone to it, there's your URL, instagram.com/your username/channel. So that's your very own IGTV channel URL. Then you have actually a saved column. So any images that you have saved will be right here for your quick review. And then any images or posts that you've been tagged in will also be right here. So this is something that you can view on mobile. It's something that I usually keep a close eye on, and I remove myself from any posts that actually aren't relevant to me. But this is where people will actually be able to see what you're tagged in, just like I was able to over on Amy's profile. So that's the general gist of Instagram on desktop and all the tools and features that you have access to over on Instagram.com. So now that you're familiar with Instagram.com, I want to introduce you to Facebook's Creator Studio. So it's just business.facebook.com/creator-studio. And this is where Facebook actually brings together all of your pages into one area. Now, if you take a look at this note right here, it says that we can now manage Instagram messages in an inbox. This is great. So if you're not one to want to type using your phone, you can actually reply to your direct messages on desktop. So let's get started. Now that I've connected my Instagram account, when I mouse on over to Instagram Direct, I can see the direct messages that someone just sent me. How great is this? Now I can just respond directly to my friend Remco and type it out. Wonderful. I love this feature from being able to handle DMs on desktop. Now, one more area where I wanted to share with you that this feature is available is over on your page. So if you manage a Facebook page, you also have an inbox section where, again, you can get access to Instagram Direct after you have already connected your Instagram profile to your page. So you've got a couple options: Creator Studio, which brings all your pages into one area, or you can go to your page directly, head on over to your inbox, and you can check out what's going on inside of Instagram Direct. Lastly, I wanted to show you Later, because this is also one of my favorite tools to use on desktop. So yes, it's a scheduling tool, but when you're under the Conversations tab, you can actually manage your comments from desktop here as well. So I just posted an image not too long ago, and I can see that there are some comments coming in. I've responded to these ones, but I haven't responded to these two. So I can just mouse on over where it says click to reply, and already I can type out a response. Hit reply. And there we go. I've just managed my comment from desktop. There's so much more you can do in terms of Later, including uploading all your media, which I'll show you quickly. You can also plan out your calendar. So once your media is uploaded, you can simply drag it on over and write out your caption, create a link to your bio if you'd like, add a location, there's hashtag suggestions, you can even save hashtags if you'd like. So this tool is all available all on desktop. I won't go in depth on it today, but I just want to let you know that it is available to use so that you can schedule, reply to comments, and even check out your analytics all from desktop. And if it isn't obvious to you yet, Later is my favorite tool to work with on Instagram from desktop because you can do so much with it, because you have the scheduling abilities, because you can manage comments, because you have the analytics, because you have that handy tool called Link in Bio, which you can take a look at and see mine in action. All of these tools allow me to get off of my phone so that I can still manage my Instagram all from desktop. Are you ready to take your Instagram strategies to the next level so that you're spending less time on your phone and making more revenue to your business? I invite you to take my free Instagram masterclass. The link is right in the description of this video. It's on demand, so you can join right now and let's start making revenue from social media. Even with phones getting, think she's on her phone all day? Try it again. Ready to kick your strategies to the next levels? Yeah.